Hello children, in the previous class you have learnt definition of work and energy. So what is work? When you apply force on an object, because of the force, if it causes displacement of an object or movement, when the object moves because of the force applied, then work is done. That is called work. And what is energy? It is the ability or capacity to do work, okay, or strength to do work. That is called as energy. And we all obtain energy from food we eat, isn't it? How do we get energy? We get energy from food that we eat. So whether it is small work or heavier work, so every work needs energy. So some of the work need less energy, some of the work need lot of energy, but all work require energy for processing. Okay, so now let us see forms of energy. So we obtain energy from food that we eat. In the same way, different objects require energy to different work. So how do these objects, what form of energy do they possess? Let us see now. So forms of energy. Energy exists in different forms. Okay, so first of all, we have mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. So what is mechanical energy? It is the energy that possesses by an object because of its position or movement or motion. Motion means movement. So when an object moves, so the moving object has mechanical energy. In the same way, object gets its mechanical energy from its position. So what is that? For example, so you all know that we produce electricity from water, isn't it? So water is used for producing electricity. So how they will produce electricity? First, they will store water in a dam, isn't it? At a height, they'll allow the water to store in a dam. So you know the dam, isn't it? Dams are built to store water. Clear? So after storing the water, what they'll do? They'll allow this water to fall down. Okay? While producing electricity, they'll allow this water to fall down from that height. So when the water falls down, it moves the turbines. Turbines are wheel-like structures. Okay? The larger ones. So the water that falls from a height has the energy. Because of that energy, it rotates the turbines. So when the turbines rotate, they produce electricity. Okay, that you can see in Job. Clear? So this water that is stored in a dam has mechanical energy. Okay, here it is stored at a height. So, because of this height, it has possesses mechanical energy. Okay, that energy is called as mechanical energy. As it is having energy, when it falls down from a height, it has the ability to rotate the turbines. Clear? So, that energy is called as mechanical energy. In the same way, another example. So, the arrow that is stretched in a bowstring. So, for example, you will take this bowstring like this and you stretch the arrow in this way, isn't it? And when you release the string, what happens? This arrow moves forward in the air. So here, the moving arrow has mechanical energy. In the same way, when it is stretched backward, also consists of mechanical energy. So as it is having energy, when you release the string, it moves forward. So if it is not possessing energy, it will not move forward. Clear? So it possesses mechanical energy. Okay, that energy is called as mechanical energy. So this is the first form of energy. So object possesses this energy due to their position or motion. Okay, due to position or motion. Motion means movement. When an object moves, it possesses mechanical energy. Or when an object is placed in a height, it also possesses mechanical energy. So here, for example, water stored in a dam, when it is allowed to fall down, When it falls from a height, it has the ability to rotate the turbine and it produces electricity. Hence, here the water that is stored in a dam has mechanical energy. So in this way, object possesses mechanical energy due to their position or motion. Okay, this is the first form of energy. And the second form of energy is electrical energy. So, large number of devices that you use at your houses. For example, you have computers, you have television, then refrigerator, washing machine, then bulbs, isn't it? So, how do, and also fan, all these things, how do they run? They run with the help of electric energy, isn't it? They need electricity to run. If there is no electricity, they don't run. Can you run your washing machine without electricity? Not possible, isn't it? In the same way, even refrigerator, does it work without electricity? No. So, at night, if you don't have electricity, do your bulbs light up? No, isn't it? So, they need electric energy to run, okay? So, that energy is called as electric energy. So, this energy is generated in the power stations. So, as I said, Job, you have Mahatma Gandhi power station. So, it produces electricity with the help of flowing water. Okay, so that is circulated to all the houses and we use that electrical energy for running different devices. Okay, this is the another form of energy, electrical energy. So next we have sound energy. So for this example, the devices that run through electrical energy are, example, computer, then TV, washing machine, etc. Okay, etc. So all these devices run through electricity. So first form is mechanical energy, second one is electrical energy, third one, this form of energy is sound energy. So what is sound energy? Sound energy means when an object vibrates, it produces sound. Okay, so that is called as sound energy. So for example, you can hear the horn of a vehicle, isn't it? Or you can hear the music. When a dog barks, you can hear it. So what happens when all these objects vibrate? They produce sound, and this sound is able to travel through the air, water, wood or metal, etc., and it reaches our ear. So when it reaches our ear, we can hear that sound. So that is called as sound energy. Okay, it is possessed by vibrating an object. So it is the another form of energy. So object possesses sound energy by vibrating. Clear? So next form of energy is heat energy. So what is heat energy? So heat means you need something. This is needed to, for example, while cooking you need heat, isn't it? You will cook food by heating the food or the object, whatever you are using for cooking. In the same way, you will boil water, isn't it? For that you need heat. So it is a form of energy. Here the main source of heat energy is sunlight, okay? Sun is the main source of heat energy. He also produces heat, isn't it? So when you stand under the sunlight, you feel hot, clear? So that is because he produces heat energy. So other forms of heat energy, other sources are when you burn fuel. So while boiling water, you will burn fuel load, isn't it? In the same way, you will burn kerosene, you will burn coal. Next, you will burn petroleum gas. For example, in a cylinder, while cooking food, you will use your cylinder gas, and inside that, what is filled? That is LPG, means petroleum gas, liquefied petroleum gas. So, when you burn these things, it produces heat. So, that is called as heat energy. So, by using this heat energy, you can cook food, you can boil food, or you can warm up yourself. Clear? So this is the another form of energy, heat energy. So next form is light energy. So this is light energy. This is another form of energy, and it is very important for us to sustain our life. Means, so you can see things around you, isn't it? You can see things around you because of light that is available in your surrounding. So if you do not have light, means when you are in the darkness, can you see things around you? Not possible, isn't it? So you need light to see things around you. So that light is called as light energy. Here, main source of light energy is the sun, okay? Sunlight is the main source of light energy. So, during daytime, you can see things around you because of sunlight that is available in your surrounding. In the same way, other sources of light energy are during darkness. So, when there is darkness, how do you see things around you? You will use, means during night, what will you use? You will use torch, then you will use tube lights, bulbs, isn't it? And candles, torch, etc. So, these are all the sources of light energy. Here they produce light, and because of that light you can see things around you. So this is the another form of energy, and this light energy main source is sunlight, and the sunlight is needed for living beings to sustain their life, because of the light energy leaves produce their food, isn't it? Leaves perform the function of photosynthesis by utilizing the sunlight, clear? So they need sunlight to prepare their food, and we are all dependent on those things for our food. So this is the main source of energy. Okay, sun is the main source of light energy, and it is very important for our life. Other sources are torch, then candle, etc., tube light, bulbs, etc. So all these produces light, and because of that light you can see things around you. So these are all the different forms of energy. So by using these different forms, we can perform different work. Clear? So mechanical energy, electrical energy, sound energy, heat energy, and light energy are the different forms of energy. I hope you understood. In the next class, let us see what are the different sources of energy. Thank you.